That's a very good question.
Yes, I just asked it.
I'm trying to remember what actual... I left, and whatever that very nice dress was at the manor. The last day we were at the manor, I got that dark outfit that had the silver necklace that I couldn't wear, because it was that annoying. That's the best way I could describe it. I think that's literally the only thing I had besides my explorer's outfit and this sun vomit outfit.
He notices you're taking a long time. He's like, sit down. I'll get your measurements again.
But you already have them.
I have the ones he told me.
Okay,
I'm going
fine.
To get them for real.
Wait, I am still curious as to how accurate he was.
Me too. Mm-hmm. All right, I'll sit down.
And just how much... How...
Oh, wait. About how long does it take?
Well, I'm just going to finish up with this guy, and if you want to come back, I'm going to do her measurements first.
Okay, I'm going to go check my dog, and I'll be back.
All right.
To the blacksmith I go.
So, he finished, like, he was literally almost done with the measurements of this guy and pinning his suit and stuff. So he gets undressed right there in the store, shop. What do you even call a shop? In the
tailor's. Sounds more like one long building. One workshop.
More of a workshop, yeah.
Yeah.
So, the villager gets undressed there and puts on his clothes and walks away.
Not like Elspeth isn't used to seeing things like that.
And the tailor's just like, alright, your turn.
And since you're going to get to know each other so intimately here, what is your name?
I thought everybody knew my name.
We're still new.
Ah.
Don't do it.
Oh god, he's thinking.
Don't do what?
Oh, I know what you're thinking. Because I thought it already.
Armani.
My name is Brian.
Brian?
Brian.
Later on, I'll tell you, when we're done, I'll tell you what I was thinking you were going to say. Because that's something I would have said.
Is there already a Brian in here?
There shouldn't be.
Don't think so.
No, there's not.
So, Brian
the Taylor.
Because
there's a Morvan Eddington, Edward Notes, Tia Gart, Chandra Charge, Frida Breast, Cinnabon, Barrel.
Cinnabon.
So,
Gerald,
well,
who's
I'm Elspeth.
Who's sweet?
I'm a doctor. Pleasure to meet
Pierre,
you.
Johan.
What's
Guy,
that?
Dude, Lola.
I heal. I repair the sick.
Oh, you're a healer.
Oh, and Dinek.
Well, sort of.
You're a doctor.
I don't have magic.
Have you talked with the clerics at the temple? I'm sure they would be glad to have your help.
Very briefly.
Oh, well, excellent. Up on the stool.
While you're doing your measurements, how about telling me more about these people at the temple? Because like I said, it's been very brief introductions there.
What is there to know? They worship,
I don't even know the cleric's name.
They worship
Nor
something.
Oh, okay.
I mean, they're Catholics and they're clerics. They're clerics and acolytes and whatever. I don't really go in for all of that stuff.
Oh, you don't?
Nah.
That's quite interesting.
I have my own little shrine. It's fine. That's all I need.
Gotcha. Understood.
And he just starts measuring. Meanwhile, at the blacksmith's, clang, 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 clang.
I don't even talk to him. I just go straight back to the stables to find my dog.
And he peeks up, finally, silence suddenly. He's like, oh, hi.
Hi, I'm checking out my dog.
Oh, he's around the side.
Thank you. Enjoy your... beating. I don't know. Work.
It's like, it's called smithing.
Smithing.
Clang, clang. Whoosh, whoosh.
Got it. How's my dog?
A blessed arrangement. A dream within a dream.
Do you go in and
yes.
Open the gate?
I assume.
Strength check.
Oh my god. 20.
You have to step, take one step back as he is jumped onto your shoulders and licks your face. His tongue covers the entirety of it.
So he gotten bigger?
Yeah, he's slightly bigger. He's a grown boy.
Wow.
He is very heavy.
Down, boy. You're heavy. Please. Hand the animal. 25.
He gets down, and he even sits.
Pet him. Like, I don't have a good place to put you. I'm just petting him. Like, I need a good place to put you. Maybe one this circle.
This is how you are literally petting him.
Yeah.
At chest level. When he's sitting.
Good lord, he's gotten big fast.
He's probably about the size of a horse by the time he's done growing.
He's a big boy.
Might be larger than a horse. Think like a Clydesdale.
That's big.
Yeah. Like, you're a good boy. I need a brush, and all my brushes are in my stuff back at the house.
This is the stables.
Yes, I'll go looking for a brush.
You easily find one.
Okay.
Just hang it up.
I'll spend time petting him, brushing him, and trying to train him some little bit of, like, tricks here and there, like sit, stand, walk, roll over. And then after about an hour or so, like, okay, I gotta go do something, I'll be back later. Usher him back into his gate.
You are covered in fur.
Yes.
Because it just went everywhere.
Gather a big ball of it and take it with me.
Alright.
I'm just out of curiosity. She doesn't know about this type of thing. She just takes the big old ball back to the tailor.
Well, they might be able to use it for something.
Exactly my thought.
Okay.
You go back to the tailor.
Hello, I'm back.
Oh yes, have a seat. I'm nearly finished with taking her measurements.
God, what can I do with this ball?
He looks over and like...
Fur.
You're going to have to ask the weavers.
Okay, thank you. I go over and talk to the weavers about it.
Alright.
Probably the same one I talked to when I first walked in.
She's working. She's like, oh!
What can I do with this? Could you use it? I don't even know.
Yeah, we could spin that into a yarn. She feels it, plays it. It'd be alright.
Because I have a lot more of this. Where this comes from. Okay.
We can make you as much cloth as you want from it.
Okay.
Well,
in the future,
as long as there's more supply. I mean, yeah. There is a limit to things, but...
Yeah. In the future, I may ask for a garment made from this bit of the fur.
Oh, well, you'll have to ask the tailor about it. We
I
just
know,
make
but
cloth.
I just... Can you, like, stockpile the cloth for me?
Yeah!
Thank you.
Totally.
Where do I put this?
She's like, oh, just over there.
I go just over there and throw it on the floor or over a table.
On top of a barrel.
There you go. Okay, I'll be back. Go back to the tailor, sit down.
Meanwhile, inside the house.
What are we doing so I can stop researching archetypes here? My eyeballs are starting to blur.
Nayoloth continues teaching you. And when he's not teaching you, he is kind of off on his own.
Okay. Are you still teaching me the language? Or...
More like he's trying to teach you more about his ways.
Of what? Magic? What do I roll for that?
Nothing, he's just...
explaining it to you.
He's explaining it.
It's going
and
well.
He's explaining it in Draconic.
Yep.
Oh, good lord.
Okay.
He wants to make sure you got it down pat.
Should I roll?
No, roll an intelligence. Sure, why not?
Five, six, seven, eight.
So.
Eight intelligence.
All right, roll again. It is way over your head.
18 intelligence.
You are starting to get the concept.
Okay. I wonder how many years have passed.
I know, right?
Heels in the mage.
Oh, wow.
By the time we get back, she's level, like, 3 in a hero class.
And we just got close.
Yeah. Like, I got close. What have you guys been doing?
12, 15, 14 intelligence.
It's still above you.
14, 15, 16, 17 intelligence. This is a very...
You're getting more of the concepts, but he's now tired of teaching. And he wants you to teach him about cooking.
31 cook profession. She teaches him some, I guess, now in her book, simple dishes, which are more complex compared to the normal commoner person after everything that happened in that manor.
So normally when you're teaching someone to cook, you start with breakfast and go soups and then more advanced things from there.
Well, he already was kind of taught breakfast, so yeah. I'm going to say you graduated him to porridge.
Oh, you're on soups. You're at line one. Oh, it was a 3. With the camera for you, the same 0 sense.
With a 31, you just taught him porridge. Just teaching him porridge.
So, eventually, he's sitting down at the table with you, and he's like, all right, obviously you know things are not the same here as they are outside.
Uh-huh. Spotted about that time?
Yep. I messed up something bad.
What did you mess up?
I wanted to give us a little bit more time to have you learn Draconic, and, well, apparently, however this house was made enhanced my spell.
By how much?
We have been trapped in here.
It's really hard to know how long you've been trapped somewhere without a real way to tell time.
That's right.
It's great.
Do you know... So what do you mean, like... Everything's still happening beyond the wall?
Sort of. In a very, very slow motion.
How far are we
headed? And that means we're going quite fast?
You could perceive it that way.
How much time would have passed?
It's not...
For us.
It's not knowable.
What about outside of it?
That's not knowable either.
Any ideas on how to get out of it?
I've been working on that for undetermined amount of time.
To them, it's barely been an hour. To us,
actually, to them, it hasn't even been a nanosecond.
Yeah, I saw you guys moving at like lightning speed when I turned back. I just saw blurs.
Yep.
Yeah.
Wow, okay,
so
yeah.
You still got a while more to be here from my gathering since the bubble was still there when we were walking away.
And in all reality, you're still technically retching on the ground.
I probably haven't made it to the ground yet.
Nope.
Oh my goodness.
By the time we get back, you're gonna be so old.
Oh, please no. She's already the eldest.
You're gonna be super the eldest.
Shut up. So, how should we go about this?
I just have to figure it out.
Oh.
Hopefully before you run out of food. You have noticed that most of the vegetables and fruits of your garden are mostly gone.
Why are they all mostly gone? Oh, goodness.
Because we've eaten them? Or rather, you've eaten them.
I'm very confused here. Out of character, very confused.
He has a ring of sustenance. He doesn't have to eat, drink, sleep.
and he knows that he screwed up, so he's been trying not to eat your only food source with you.
And the only one that could have actually dealt with it just fine is the one of the two people that left.
Or no, because once you run out of blood, that's it for you too.
And then don't have to eat, drink, sleep, anything.
Yeah. It's just...
I want to.
Yeah.
I don't have to. It's not a requirement. It's a unnatural desire.
Oh, okay.
Okay, well, probably would have been a bit important to have told me that way earlier. I could have cut back.
I mean...
I was hoping that I would have figured this out already. Which is partly why I sent your friend Annase out into the village.
To do what?
To get her out of the bubble. And I was correct about what I thought she was. She didn't die immediately. Or at least I don't think she hasn't died immediately.
I can't tell. She's only moved like a half inch.
Yeah.
Half an inch. Oh, goodness. Oh, boy. Everything's just like... Oh, goodness. So I guess we just twiddle our thumbs until we figure something out?
I mean, on the side, you have unlimited time. Sort of.
The more experienced person figures it out?
Yep.
Oh, boy.
You also have a lot of teleportation circles. But you still may die immediately. I don't know how this is going to work for you.
At that point, she should be studying the teleportation at the teleportation in time.
That would be difficult to do. Because there are no books on teleportation in the study or anywhere
in
the
house. No, I meant like the bubble.
Study the bubble.
She's gonna study
what happens to this vegetable when I throw it outside the bubble? Science.
At that point, she should.
I don't know if I would use a vegetable, but yes.
Maybe she'll use an object and throw it over the wall.
A leaf? Well, couldn't you just take your ring off and give it to her, and then after a week it'll work? That she won't die immediately, and then you can catch up slowly. That's a waste of time.
Right, then the only one who could break the magic
dies. Yep.
Dies.
Yeah.
And then she's trapped forever.
Like, literally the only source of info you have is him and the books that you two have.
Ruffin!
I still don't even know what his is.
She can't even read.
You can read it now.
She tried.
I mean, yours, not his.
Oh yeah, you completely understand your book inside and out.
Yeah. So the only source of info you have is him and that book.
Oh boy. So, well, that just brings us to...
And then a whole bunch of horticulture books.
Figuring out what to do now.
Alright.
Not really much else to think about other than...
I've been like scaling time slowly in my head. Till if a nanosecond has barely passed and I've only moved like slightly, yet I turned around and saw them moving at lightning speed. There's gonna be years.
It's indeterminate. Quit trying to figure it out.
Well, you will know how much time has passed because I have to eat you.
I should have just made my character super young.
Oh, how old is she?
23!
Yeah,
she's the eldest out of all three of
She'll
us.
She'll be a crone by the time he figures this out.
I will hurt you.
I won't be that old. Roll a d10.
They always thought 50s were early death crones.
I mean, to be fair, though, like...
6.
Alright, so after a while, Nayoloth finally comes to you and is like, I think I figured it out.
It's a blood sacrifice.
I'm gonna sacrifice a virgin. Oh, no.
Okay.
Elspeth left.
So I'm pretty sure I need to be in the exact spot where I cast it in the first place.
Okay.
And I need you to be in the exact spot when I cast it also.
What am I rolling?
An intelligence with a -5.
Ooh.
12.
Ooh.
You know that you were outside.
We were outside. We gotta make our way outside.
He's like, well, I'm. I know for certain I was right here in this spot. I think you were behind me near the door.
Okay, I got to stand by the door. I wasn't the one. Standing near the door. Okay.
Yeah, he's like, all right. This might not work. I don't know what's going to happen if it doesn't work.
It's always interesting when we add time to things,
huh? Uh-huh. Adds a whole new layer.
Time.
What's a five dimension? Wait.
So he casts what he thinks is what's supposed to happen, and then he's done.
I don't know how Pathfinder Magic works, but in D&D this would suck, because you're cut off from it.
Oh!
All you have is what you brought with you.
Okay.
Huh?
What now?
In D&D, magic is more like a thing that's ever present in the air. And around you, and in nature, and in everything. So if you cut yourself off by stopping time, you have what you have with you in your bubble. And Pathfinder, I have no idea how it works. Just, as far as I know, it's just granted to you by the gods, but I don't know how. Well, except for Arcane.
What? I guess.
Reflex.
16. Reflex.
You step back as a bird goes right in front of your face.
Man. Would have sucked. How many other things? A bird took her out of Mach 400 billion.
Rest in a beacon the temple.
Wouldn't be a beacon of temple, there'd be no temple.
You see Nayoloth looking around like, oh no, it didn't work.
No, he just super sped it up.
What, them in the house or everything around them? She's just like, what
was
that?
Looks back to you, I'm sorry.
You're gonna start feeling the bone ache soon.
I don't think it worked. Have you noticed anything different?
Well, I'm stinking perception. 27. Perception.
I mean, with a 27, you do notice everything outside is moving again.
But at what speed?
It appears to be normal speed.
She's gonna go over to the front gate.
So you're gonna...
I'm not gonna walk out.
Completely ignore his question.
Wait, what was this question?
Have you noticed anything?
Have you noticed anything?
No, I haven't
different?
Noticed anything different right. Other than a bird.
Okay, so you tell him there was a bird.
Yes, there was a bird.
Then he's like, oh, it worked then.
Then she goes.
And he walks with me and he's like, ah, if I had been wrong, instead of freezing time for everybody else, I would have sped ourselves up even faster.
84 percentile. Okay, that's good to know.
Back to the nonplussed ego thing.
Yep. It's been a while since we've seen that one. She went to horrific shock for a couple sessions and now she's
I will stab
back
you.
To the stone wall.
Shut up.
Well, stone wall. Neither one of us is there.
Well, we're going over the front gate.
Everybody You're going out the front gate?
Not going out of the front gate. I'm going to the front gate and looking from the front gate.
She's so, like, are you sure?
I feel like I have to be explicitly specific.
As
I'm
you,
going to the front gate, then it
as you go
the
into
outside,
the front,
I'm not passing.
The front yard, you can... these two are walking away.
It did work! Okay. Let's not do spells like that.
Yes,
at least not on this property.
I wasn't expecting that to happen.
I don't think
I thought maybe we could slow time for a bit enough to teach you about most of the stuff in the backyard. But, I mean, it worked out just fine. You've totally learned the language. Isn't that what you wanted?
Yep.
By the way, you are now 6 years older.
Oh.
That is a long time in a bubble.
And now,
imagine having to literally sit there and feel 6 years pass without a nanosecond, hardly.
And without knowing.
Yep. Usually, I mean, it's been a long time. I haven't slept, I don't feel like.
Yep.
It's even funnier. Your character is a year older.
Sort of.
Chronologically, yes.
Chronologically, I'm 18 now.
Aww, and I'm
still 19.
Yep.
Because I got out. I got out soon enough.
Okay.
I have to have asterisks next to my age now. 17,
18. So, Nayoloth just goes back in, makes a cup of tea, sits down at the table.
Eothain's gonna go tend to the garden, I guess. See what the damage has been done with this time circle.
Everything's fine.
Looking good. Oh, great.
I'm
not gonna do that again.
Well, considering it cost you 6 years for like 5 minutes.
Not even five minutes.
Barely a nanosecond.
At most, a quarter of a second has passed in reality.
That's mind-boggling.
I have to do the math now.
I know not to do that again.
I would hope
what else is amplified.
I'm gonna hope he's learned not to just cast spells willy-nilly around the house.
How long has the read magic? I'm sorry, comprehend language has been cast on me exactly, I wonder.
Never actually came back to cast it on you after he put up the bubble.
Yeah. Wait.
No, he did cast it on you after the bubble once.
Yeah.
And it lasted the entire time.
Wow.
But I wonder if that's amplified, if it's still, like, there. I don't know. We'll find out later.
Imagine if he cast it detonate.
Oh. That would have taken out the entire village.
I cast magic missile at the flower because it's funny. What the?
What is going on? Stop it! The flower is dead long ago!
You're drilling a hole to Mormouth.
Yep. Nothing will get you them. At that point, we should go to the Underdark.
Ugh. You got history there, too.
It was a happy history. It was really like, fun. I had real good history down there. Well,
do you go forth into the village?
No.
Because although you don't know for certain how much time has passed inside the house, you know it's been a very long time.
Yeah, for them in the house. But there's absolutely zero difference between the two because she just watched these two walk away.
Yep. For us, but inside the house, like, it's 6 years older.
Yeah, she's exploring the house, trying to figure out what's changed, but she's also lived in the house that entire time, so...
I know, that's why she knows that it's been a long time, but not certain how long.